is going on, people in the 90s? Your boy Elector360 here. We are back playing more Metro Exodus. A lot has happened in the last video. We were out. Hold on. Close that. We were out, finding. No, wait. We were out, like, looking for radio signals or stuff like that. And, well, we ran into a bunch of people who were enemies, and we ended up in a factory, which got us into this predicament. We also found a transmitter, and we broke it and released all those signals. It was typically a jammer, and apparently the colonel, the one that we've been with since the last two games of Metroid, knew all about him. It's just so funny. The more people keep putting these things that governments know about in this game, and you just get less and less trustful to any of them at all, because that's me. I hope I'm not the only one with this, because I'm right now having a hard time expressing the fact that our commander knew, Miller knew, that there were other people outside of Moscow, and the fact that he did, and there was a jammer in place, and he knew about it, makes it me want to shoot him.
has a goal to strive for because of you. We all remember the way you fought back in D6, so no matter what lies ahead, we're with you. You can count on us. Yes, as for me, I'm running a little inventory check. It is kind of cramped in here. I'm thinking of making something of a workbench. So that's all the instruments we get, and everything else would be within arm's reach. With no workbench, you just lose small components. We'll use this place to work on the weapons. Cleaning, oiling, keep out of everybody's way, and keep them from messing with my stuff. Ah, well, we'll have to take turns, of course, but we'll manage. So, if you find any weapons you'd like to keep, I'll store them for you here on the Aurora, and you can come back to exchange them. You'll get them back in their best shape ever, don't you doubt. Boy, have I cleaned and oiled a lot of weapons in my life. Factory, and homemade too. Some of those were just amazing, so unusual. So, if you have any weapon-related questions, I'm your man. And weapons, they are like girls. They need attention. You clean your weapon well, you oil it, you check the ammo, because these dirty ammo caps do get rusty sometimes. But if you put your heart into it, the weapon never fails. I'll just finish oiling this one, then start on another.
Well, hello there, Tony. People could have called me out there to drink to Aurora. I still think Beelzebub was a better name. By the way, did you come to trade places with me? Or did you just want some exercise? I heard that. Monotonous labor calms you. Well, it's no lie. I do feel this calm, you see? Idiot says it's dynamic meditation. That philosopher doesn't come here to meditate often. Well, help yourself.
Because frankly speaking, I'm a bit tired here.
The only good thing about this job is that you forget it's winter.
Surely you didn't have to pay for this comfort later. With your whole body.
I literally have no idea what I'm doing. Okay, I don't think there's a point to this.
After all those years in the underground, the air of the surface seemed incredibly fresh, intoxicating. But that was not what had caused the crew's euphoria. our journey finally got a definite purpose provided by the transmission from the government bunker in the Urals. For 20 years, we thought that neither the government nor military high command had survived. Turns out they're still around. Where were they while we were eating each other alive in the metro? We'll have a lot of questions for them once we reach Yamantau. If we reach it. The ruins of our country are under enemy control, according to Miller. And we'll have to fight through to our goal. A small team against the occupation armies? What are the chances that we'll succeed? That we'll get some answers?
I mean, you took down a whole army in the first metro. You stopped basically a war. What's happening? I have no idea what's happening. Oh, there we go. I got scared there. I thought it froze.
Froze anything off yet, darling? Here, let's warm you up a little bit. So, what do you think our chances of getting to Yamantau alive are? It's the only thing on my father's mind. How to earn his forgiveness. Get back to Metro and his old life, the life you had always been running from. And to think, I never believed you. And now I'm looking at this fog, thinking it could actually be hiding our new life from us. By the way, we should be approaching the bridge soon. Damn it! A campfire! People! There are people there! Hit the bridge! Nice, here's our new map.
Yes, sir.
I need you to recon the immediate area.
Got that, sir. in reserve.
Yes, sir.
Artyom, don't forget your backpack. It's a new module. A portable workshop, so to
speak. Oh.
The manual is inside. It doesn't come with crafting materials, though, so keep an eye out for those.
Oh, God. Just like Dying Light.
Just be careful out there.
Sure thing.
Well, that's all. Good luck, guys.
Chemicals come first. Bones, fertilizer, shit like that. Then, of course, nuts, balls, feathers, crap. They like that stuff because they can basically eat anything. But you should get out. The manual is inside. It says for where to look.
I found lots of stuff in Nocellus's lairs back in Moscow. When they get someone, they often drag the body there to feed their young.
Nope. Okay. I still don't know what the moral points, which is why I wanted to pause this for a second. I did do some research, and there is moral points, but there's no videos about them. So I'm basically going to be playing this game just like I play any other game regularly, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to get a bad ending. 100%, like I did with the other ones.
What was that? Could you check it out?
Nothing. Something's gonna scare me.
I took a look around while you were inside. That electric tower there looks like a perfect sniping position. Let's go.
I thought that was something, a monster, a dead monster or something, but no, that's just a prank. That's a tree.
Look, a rabbit.
That is one big ass rabbit. That does not look normal. Again, I would really appreciate, I would really loved it if they would make him talk. Like, that would have been much a better experience.
I'll climb up there while you take the boat to the church. I'll call you when I'm set.
I see something. I hate the water. I hate it. I hate it. I'm gonna get eaten. Your husband's gonna get eaten. I hate this. What do you mean, where am I, comrade?
Looks like you've been spotted. Artyom, there's a woman on that bell tower waving a rag or something. Please investigate. I see people at the church. None seem to be armed. We'd better try the open approach. Let's not fire first, okay?
Hang on, because I'm trying to turn up the noise. I mean, the audio. Oh my god, I'm such an idiot.
Oh.
I'm just listening to this just in case there's a moral point. I don't know why. I just want to know. That's something I wanted. Soon, our brother's militant will be here. Come and on. The Lord's justice will be done. I'm having a likes and dislikes 50-50% with this guy.
Heretics, but I'll tell you everything I've seen in this place all that year.
Arriving under the cover of fog.
Oh, it's the bridge guard. Silentius fooled them just like the locals. But unlike them, the bridge guard have guns. Run! There's a way out down here, and there's a boat at the dock.
We also have one, but it's too small for all of us.
Artyom, she's right. Get to the boat. We will rescue her later. Don't worry.
Go! Nastya and I can get to your train by ourselves.
Guess I'm supposed to go the other way.
Have you found him yet? Or should I look for him myself, brethren?
The devil is looking out for his foe.
Send for him!
I can see
I'm over there.
Sorry. Oh, I didn't know I could do that. Things, other things makes things much more easy. Oh, and I could collect them too.
Was here for sure. I couldn't have just imagined it. God protect me. Yes, looks like it was Satan's trickery after all. Fish, protect me and shield me from evil.
getting intense. Oh my god.
I give up. I have no choice but to rely on your mercy. Even...
Oh. Well, I tried.
Are you all right? Great. I was starting to worry. You raised some hell in there. I just kiss you right now. Though I've got to take Katya and Nastya to the Aurora, so see you there. Check the map. Looks like you can roll straight there from your position.
Jesus Christ. Oh no. That was what I was afraid of.
What the fuck was that? A whale? It's fucking huge!
The old man sent me out as a forward sentry. Told me that I was to sit tight and under no circumstances look for any action. So I just had a front row seat watching you there. And so you subdue the occupation forces peacefully with a holy cross and a prayer. Anna has already reported on the cult. How about we trade places? I'd hate to come back to Moscow without even firing once. I was trying to win a girl over from one trader. Tough luck there. Why does everybody else get fun missions? The colonel does criticize you and all, but he gives you all the best action. Is this his way of showing affection or trying to get you killed? But I have to say it's unfair. I've been dragged out of Moscow and for what? Stalking the furnace and sitting in a bog with a dumb spyglass. Here, though, we do have a chance of finding some loot. There is this plane there. Just leave something for me. I'll have to stay longer, I suspect. The shrimps are giving me trouble, though. I wish I could somehow talk to that catfish into chomping all those water bugs. How did Mowgli talk to the animals, I wonder? Speaking of Mowgli, we have the same blood type, you and I, haven't you noticed? Well, I guess you have to go now, Artyom. I feel your father-in-law training his binoculars on us to turn us into pillars of salt.
That sounds important.
After the horrors Duke told us about. Let's go. Dad's talking to Katya right now. They are so nice. Both Katya and her daughter. And Katya's medical training will come in handy.
Thank you for the information, Katya. But there is one more question I need to ask.
But of course.
What do you know of the occupation forces?
Huh? I'm sorry, I don't quite get what you...
So, you've never seen any foreign army in this area?
No, I haven't seen any army. But we haven't really been to any important places.
I see. Artyom, a moment.
Thank you, Artyom. If not for you, we'd never have escaped that place. They were so busy looking for you. And then Anna picked us up.
Yes, Uncle Artyom, thank you. And your wife is great. She's kind and really strong. Thank you, Auntie Anna.
There you go, Artyom. As I always said, you lucked out with me.
We all lucked out with Anna. She's a total deadeye. Now I only wish your mom could come with us too. With a real medic, we'd become unstoppable. Katya, Nastya, come have some tea. Don't be shy.
Thank you.
So, Katya, where are you from?
The Southern Ural. A couple of years ago, we heard there was this great place on the Volga, so we made the journey. Who could have known that fanatics were in control now? And they say this place used to be great.
Did you come with your husband?
There were 15 of us, but now only Nastya and I are alive.
I'm sorry. Hey, why are you so gloomy? Don't you like the tea?
I do.
Oh, when the gargoyle attacked, Nastya lost her teddy. The beast carried it away. Must have thought it was alive.
Oh, don't you worry. We'll find your teddy. Huh. We call them demons in Moscow. And you call them gargoyles.
Yes. Where did those things crawl out from, I wonder?
Well, there's radiation, chemical weapons and stuff. Nature just went strange.
Yeah, the planet's been trashed. No wonder Silantius had such a hold over everyone here, with people seeing things like that every day. Poor fools. They live in darkness and die just like that, ridden with disease. I'm a trained nurse, but Silantius wouldn't even hear of me treating anyone. He said God claims his own. He only cares about feeding their bodies to that fish once they die. He says it's their sure way into heaven. I tried doing something to help them, but no. It's a sin. And then he just locked us up in that tower. And somehow a stupid flashlight made it worse.
Uncle Crest gave me the flashlight, but Silantius got mad and smashed it.
He did, and then he cursed Crest. So the man had to hide in the port. It's a basement lair, so Silantius can't get him there.
He also wanted to make Mommy marry him, but she didn't want to. He's old and nasty. Ah.
Yes, the Gospel of the Damned Fish says nothing about marriage. I was lucky to protect my daughter. That crazy creep, he's just so...
Moral points. Moral points.
Of course we will. Don't you worry.
Artyom, stop by my desk once you're done talking to the old man. I've got something for you.
Great job saving them, Artyom. Katya here has provided us with vital information. A mechanic called Crest is hiding in the port. His help is required if we're to fix the Aurora in the foreseeable future. Yermak can't handle the repairs alone. So once you're ready, go to the port and invite Crest to join us. We'll get back ASAP. We'll have to decide what to do about the fanatics on that bridge. Now we know for sure that the bridge is in working order. They crossed it last year when they got here. Well, at least some things are clearer now. But still, so many questions. There might not even be any enemy forces around here at all. They probably garrisoned the key regions only. In any case, we'll learn everything once we reach Yamantau. From the top source. The Moscow government is essentially a local council, putting things in perspective. So, now we just need to figure out how to cross this goddamn bridge.
Replace the cylinder, but there's just no spare. I've got to fix this one, and I don't even know where to start. It usually takes a whole workshop to fix things like that. So you're going to the port to look for that mechanic? Please, do your best. Otherwise, we might as well get used to this place.
Is it comfortable? Can you operate stealthily with it? I have a present for you here. A TR rifle. Ring any bells? It's pneumatic, but it still packs a wallop. Plus, making bullets for it is easy as pie, even in the field. Just remember to keep that pressure up. Otherwise, you might as well be spitting him out yourself. Other than that, it will never fail you. I did my best. So, bear it with honor. And don't forget to drop by from time to time. I have a few ideas for improvement.
Artyom.
Hello again, Artyom. You did great out there. Or so everyone says. In the meantime, we have dug in here. We've been waiting for the occupying forces. But so far, we have only seen winged and four-legged ones. Our ecology seems to sit badly with them. Some bandit-looking characters in the distance, too.
So, Artyom, are you going to the port? There's nobody there. At least, I haven't seen any normal people. But there sure are mutants, so you'd better take care.
Take care, Artyom? The Scourge of the Dark Ones? Go get them all, Artyom. They'd better hope they can run fast enough.
That Katya lady Anna brought in? She's a nurse, so maybe you should have her look at your wound, huh? It'd make a great opener for getting acquainted, you know?
No dice. Stepan's all over her with his rugged charm. I haven't got a chance.
Artyom, are you going to the port? I'm going to relieve Alyosha now, so I can't come with you. His hand is still giving him trouble. So Katya being a nurse is just perfect. It will make convincing Dad to take them along so much easier. I'm going to talk to him about that later. Besides, he doesn't really want to leave them here himself. I can see that. But he's so hung up on those occupying forces, he can't even think of anything else. All right, you go run that errand for my father now. Just be careful out there. You know I worry about you.
This is the way. Oh, fuck that shit. Easy. Easy. Jeez. Okay. What the fuck is that? Is that a zombie? The fuck are you? Oh. First we have demons, then we have the solstice, now we have zombies. Man. It's really amazing. Oh my God. Ugh. Okay, dude. Please lower the fucking crane, please. Oh, gee, thank you.
Come up here. You're pretty amazing, Bratuha. That was crazy. Those mutants are pretty hardcore. The villagers never have a chance against them. You just cut through them, bleh. Well, it's pleasure to meet you. Name's Chris, by the way. Are you from the train? Bet the locals wouldn't even talk to you guys. Opened fire right away, didn't they? Of course, those dumb bastards. I've been here long enough to know the drill. They have a cult over there. The dumbasses are hung up on technology having destroyed the old world. So they don't exactly take kindly to smart guys here. And me... Well, they were just gonna lock me up until I agreed to go fight those electrical demons of theirs to absolve my sins. Because I was in cahoots with Satan, apparently, блядь. Some Satanist I am. I've been fixing engines and trading all my life. Now I'm moving to the east. Blin, I'm sick of this part of country. There's just nothing to do here anymore. The cities are gone. Bandits, beasts all around. Lots of space across the Volga, though. Plenty of opportunity. So, I came here with my rail car full of trading goods, hoping to make a few sales on the way east. What a fool I was. I was lucky to get out alive. Anyway, since you've arrived, I've been thinking of this little plan I had, never had a chance to pull off alone, but since you guys are also going east... Now, judging by what I could see with my binoculars, it's a miracle your engine is still running. Oh, by the way, take the binoculars. I'll show you where everything is. Look at the bridge first. See that section on top? It should lower if the emergency mechanism still works. Katya from the church should know better. I've never been to the bridge myself. There, to the right, that huge hangar. That's a terminal, Blit. The cult is considered a holy place. Covered it all in graffiti, schmaffiti. Their tsarfish lived there, you know? Stupid bastards. Even further right, see the building near all those carriages? Used to be a train depot. There are some bandits there now, but the place itself ain't bad. Oh, the area nearby isn't too bad either. There's a good hunting and stuff. I set up several safe camps around there. If you find them, you could rest, fix your equipment. Unless you prefer spending nights at an open campfire. Now, come on, let me show you my home. My cave. And this is where I live. Not a palace. One. Oh, here's a bed. So if you're tired, my home is your home. I made a workbench to tinker on. If you need ammo or grenades, there's some raw materials here. So help yourself. You can have anything you like here. Can't carry all the shit anyway. Come on, don't be shy. Oh, anyhow, gotta tell you, this isn't just a pretty place. I've got a whole lot of knowledge.
Oh, this is amazing.
fix stuff. You'll never have second thoughts about picking me up. Managed to buy some smokes from the villagers before the assholes chased me away, but... No, you could take this zipline down, just hook up and away you go. Dumb cretins didn't like my life. Yeah, I've been banned from the village and the bridge ever since. But I guess you shouldn't start the fight with me.
Or can these guys just... What the hell? Oh god, I remember those things. But I forgot it. I can't move when they're around. What do I do? I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Jesus. Oh, hey, Anna.
I heard you call me. It was so great there. But I heard you and couldn't leave you.
Someone's gonna attack me. All right, here we go. Easy as pie.
I'll just rest a bit and get going.
The old man's probably going seven sorts of crazy now, thinking his precious daughter got hurt or something.
Dad, it's me. My radio battery died. I got it wet. Other than that, I'm fine. Artyom and the guys are here.
You are getting detention once you are back, young lady. Sam, it's up to you. Thanks for helping find Anna. Now I want you to drag her butt here with extreme prejudice. Time to talk some sense into that brat. Stefan's asking for some tools. Trying to get civilians on board. Everyone's gone nuts here.
Head back. Help Stepan persuade my father about letting Katya and Nastya travel with us. Artyom, I am feeling better now. Really, I am.
So, Seth, tell me what the real enemy bases look like so that we know when we see it.
Well, time for this.
Artyom, help us here. The old man won't let Katya and Nastya come with us. Even though Katya told us where to find a passenger car in great condition.
God.
We have to go back now, I guess.
Where would you go? Those fanatics would eat you alive.
Well, maybe they... I don't know.
I mean, sure, it's not just about the space. We might have to fight our way through the bridge, and even after we do, we don't know what dangers lie ahead. But still!
And I told him I could help. I'm a medic. I also told him about the bridge, that it could be lowered. Yes, I even told him about the carriage and the train people. We came all the way here in it. It's very good.
Hi, Artyom.
Thank you. Won't let you down. Hey, Artyom. See how it all worked out?
Come here, Artyom. Have a seat. Look, we have an opportunity to cross the bridge without an assault. There are trade caravans going up the river, and the bridge dwellers do business with them.
So, disguised as such traitors, we will infiltrate the bridge and lower it. Katya says it still works. They won't be able to stop us if we move fast. And should they try, we'll cross it no matter what the fanatics think. They want blood, they will get it. So now, we only have to wait for the traitor's boat.
Colonel, sir, we can't just leave them here. They will be eaten alive.
Sipan, did you ever try using your head? Do you know where we are going? What we are going to face on the way there? Where, pray tell, are they going to sleep on the Aurora? Atop the coal crates? We Spartans can handle it. But for a woman with a 6-year-old daughter, no less, this is unacceptable.
I'll give them my bedroll and move into the stokehold.
You will fall asleep and get your throat cut the next day you get guard duty after trying to sleep there.
Still, I know we can't leave them.
Let's just collect that carriage Katya told us about while we wait. We can't leave the child here. And anyhow, how long are we going to sleep in turns for?
Are you starting that again? How? How are we going to collect that carriage? I'm not taking the Aurora there.
Oh, you don't need it. I have a rail car hidden in the terminal. It can tow a carriage like nobody's business. Artyom and I can go get it and bring the carriage back.
No way I'm letting you go. It'll take us both till morning to finish the repairs, and I can't handle it myself in time.
Okay, okay, have it your way. I'm done playing the monster here. We get that carriage. We take the civilians with us. Artyom, will you handle this? Listen, Artyom, if the caravan is sighted, drop everything and rush to the port. It's our best chance of traversing the bridge.
Thanks, Dad. Katya and Nastya will be so grateful.
Here, Artyom. It's a breaker for the rail car. It won't run without this. She's a real babe, Artyomich. No two ways about it. We went to hell and back, Hera and I. So much stuff you hold, so many tight spots she saved me from. Look, Artyom, since you're going to the terminal, hear me out. It's quite a distance away, and look, if you go at night, there's less of a chance you might run into bandits. They stay at their camps when it's dark. But it's not gonna be easy either, since more beasts come out, and there are also electrical anomalies. The fanatics call them the demons of electricity, so you should think about your options before heading out.
Artyom, Duke is on a mission in that area. He's keeping tabs on the bridge. Reception is bad there. We get mostly static from him. Anyway, if you meet him, he'll update you on the latest developments in the terminal. I bet you've conspired with Anna and Stefan. I care for those two no less than you. But we don't know if what's ahead is any better than the fanatics. I guess we'll have to live and see.
Well, that was great, but I think I'm sad to say I'm gonna have to end it here because I've gone way past my usual recording time. So I hope you enjoyed this video, even though basically I was basically looking around for moral points again, which I know there is because we just got one when we lowered the bridge and left. So there is, but I don't know where they are because this is a new game and I don't know everything. So basically I'm going to get a bad ending, nonetheless. But I don't know, maybe I'll just redo it all over again. And if they post a video about all the moral points, which I hope they do. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like, subscribe, check out my Twitter and Instagram just to give me more games and tell me everything about it. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out. We've lost.